Condemned anthropology. To emphasize the peculiar role of observation, if I return to the double slit experiment and try to sneak a look at which slit the electron really passes through the pie, placing a detector at one of its slit, the interference pattern disappears. The act of looking to see which slit the electron passes through changes the nature of the wave function describing the electron. Now, the pattern as a detector plate simply shows two regions of the light lining up with the two slits. There is no longer any interference pattern. My act of trying to know changes the behavior of the electron. Although it is a bit of a cheat, one way to think about this is to imagine an anthropologist observing a previously undiscovered Amazon tribe. Okay, so it's all about analogy, right? To observe is to alter behavior. It is impossible to observe without interacting in some fashion and changing the behavior of the tribe. This is even more evident in the case of the electron. To know which slit the electron went through means to look, but that must involve some sort of interaction. For example, it could be a photon of light bouncing off the electron and returning to a detector. But that photon must impart some change of momentum or energy or change the electron's positions. It can't interact without some change. But the truth is that this interaction need not be as obvious as a photon bouncing off our electron. It can be more subtle. If I observe whether the electron passes through one slit but don't detect it, I can infer that it passes through the other slit. But there was no photon bouncing off the electron in this case. This is an interaction-free measurement of the electron's location. Okay. There is a very strange thought experiment that exploits this act of looking as the electron passes through the slit in the screen. Suppose I could make a bomb that would be activated by a single electron hitting a sensor. The trouble is that there is no guarantee that the bomb works. Sure. Classically, the only way to test this seems to be the rather useless act of the firing an electron at the bomb. Okay. If it goes off, I know it works. If it doesn't, then that's dude. But either way, after testing, I don't have a bomb. Then weird thing is that I can use the double slit experiment to detect working bomb without setting them off. Remember that there were places on the screen where the electron can't hit if it is really going through both slits at the same time. If I detect an electron at this point, it means I must have been looking and forced the electron to choose one slit or the other. We are going to use these regions as a bomb detector region. Place the bomb sensors at the location of one of the slits, and if the bomb is a dud, the sensor won't activate it. We are making no observation if it is dud. That means the electron passes through both slits and can't hit the bomb detector region. Okay, but what if it isn't dud? It isn't dud? Well, the sensor will detect the electron if it goes through the slit and sets the bomb off. Not much good, but because now I am detecting which slit the electron is going through, it is going through only one slit and has the chance to reach our bomb detector region. So if I pick up the electron in the bomb detector region, it must mean the bomb is live. A live bomb is a detection mechanism. Half the time the electron is detected going through the slit where the bomb is located and the bomb goes off. But the other half of the time the bomb detects that the electron passes through other slit, the interference pattern can't occur. The electron has the chance to hit the bomb detector region and yet the bomb doesn't explode. The electron have given up information about which street it passed through, but the act of observation didn't involve looking at the electron or hitting it with a photon of light or blowing up a bomb. The strange implication of the act of the observation can also be applied to stop the pot of uranium on my desk decaying. By continually making lots of mini observations, trying to catch the uranium in the act of emitting radiation, the observation can freeze the uranium and stop it decaying. It's a quantum version of old adage that a watched pot never boils. But now the pot is full of uranium. Wow. Was a code-cracking mathematician Alan Turing who first realized that continually observing an unstable particle could somehow freeze it and stop it evolving. The phenomenon became known as the quantum zero effect after the Greek philosopher who believed that because instantaneous snapshot of an arrow in flight show no movement, the arrow cannot be moving at all. Wow. Think of a particle that can be in two states, here and there. Unobserved, it's in a mixture of two, but observation forces it to decide which one. If it decided to be here, then after observation it being too evolved into a mixed state again. But observe it quickly enough and it's still mostly here and will probably collapse into the here state again. So by continually observing, the particle it never evolves sufficiently into their state to have a chance of being observed there. Sure. It's like having two glasses half filled with water, but each time you observe you have to pour the water from one glass into the other, filling it to the brim. After observation, you can start to refill the empty glass, but look quickly enough and it's hardly full, and so the easiest thing is to refill the almost full glass again. By looking quickly each time, you ensure the full glass stays full. Wow. My children are obsessed with the science fiction TV series Doctor Who, just as I was a kid. The alien we find, scientists are the Weeping the Angels, stone figures like those in our local cemetery that don't move provided you don't take your eyes off them. But blink and they can move. The theory says that a pot of uranium on my desk is a bit like a weeping angel. If I keep observing the uranium, which obviously means a little more than just keeping my eyes on the pot on my desk, I can freeze it in such a way that it stops emitting radiation. Turing first suggested the idea as a theoretical consequence of the mathematics. It turns out that it is not just mathematical fiction. There have been some experimental in the last decades that have demonstrated the real possibility of using observation to inhibit the progress of a quantum system. Oh.